Next, we will start industry sector briefing session. Executive Vice President and Executive Officer, General Manager of Industry Business Division, Mr. Masakazu Aoki, will explain. We will switch the screen, so please wait for a moment. Mr. Aoki, please.
Hello, everyone. This is Aoki. I would now like to explain the business strategy of industry sector. There are three key messages today listed here. First is digital transformation accelerating in the new normal era. Second is the expansion of total seamless solutions utilizing Lumada. And third is the development for global growth. I will follow this content to explain, starting from overview of the industry sector. This is the positioning of the industry sector. So it consists of industry and distribution business unit and water and environment business unit in Hitachi Limited, as well as Hitachi Industrial Products, mainly in charge of product business, and Hitachi Industrial Equipment Systems, a total of four entities. Next is the business overview. Fiscal year 2020 revenue was 858.1 billion yen, of which industry and distribution business unit was 36% and water and environment business unit was 20%. And the mass production business was 28% and built to order built business in industrial products business was 16%. Now, if you could look at the pie graph, the solution business grew with the acceleration of DX under new normal and acquisition of automation business. So compared with the same graph 2 years ago in the IR meeting, it now accounts for 56% of the total revenue. Next is the sector structure. I continue serving as the leader and operate the sector with four CEOs and presidents here. Next is the business domain of the industry sector. From the bottom of the slide, we have products used in customers' manufacturing sites, and then OT that operate and control such facilities, and IT that manages and controls them. The broad-based business domain from workplace to management is under one sector. This is our uniqueness. Next is the progress of 2021 midterm management plan. So we made steady progress through the strengthening of the integrated operations in the industry sector, although COVID-19 has somewhat impacted the plan. Let me start from the bottom of the slide and work my way up. In response to the market change, we focused on selective investments and securing profits through fixed cost reduction and more stringent project management to respond to COVID-19 impact. To increase business resilience, we shifted resource to digital business and to accelerate DX and increase the number of solutions matched with the needs of the new normal to respond to market changes from the offense and defense. In basic policies and progress, as acceleration of expansion, we acquired JR Automation in December 2019 and established Hitachi Industrial Holdings America in April 2020 to strengthen our business base in North America. In expanding and strengthening total seamless solution, which we explained in this meeting 2 years ago, we scaled digital solution utilizing Lumada, and Lumada core business increased by 6% year on year. In April this year, we acquired Kyoto Robotics, a developer of intelligent robotic system, to expand business by further enhancing product times OT times IT. This shows fiscal year 2019 results and onward. The fiscal year 19 full year results was revenue of 909.4 billion and adjusted operating income of 7.5% excluding COVID-19 impact, an increase in both revenue and income. including the COVID-19 impact, we expected a significant decline in revenue and operating income. Therefore, we started with a forecast of 761.8 billion and 3.2% respectively. Despite difficult situation under COVID-19, we shifted to digital business and expanded our global business. Therefore, fiscal year 20 results shown in red arrows were up 96.3 billion in revenue and up 2.5 percentage points in adjusted operating income ratio against the forecast revised downward. We were able to control the significant part of COVID-19 impact. The revenue and increase are forecast to grow as a result of capturing new DX needs, despite the continued impact of COVID-19. And beyond that, we will aim for revenue of over 1 trillion yen and adjusted operating income ratio of over 10%. Next, this shows the trends of the results of the main companies we acquired, starting with JR Automation in North America. As shown on the left graph, after we acquired JR Automation in fourth quarter of fiscal year 2019, we were impacted by COVID-19 in the US in fiscal year 20, but by eagerly exploring the new demands and pursuing PMI, the orders and revenue grew considerably. And the growing business areas are, as shown on the right pie chart, we shifted from automobile-centered portfolio to a bigger portion from e-commerce and medical, growing under the new normal and accelerating the shift in our business portfolio. And furthermore, in fiscal year 2021, we will expand robotics SI business featuring the digital fusion. Next is Solair in the US. In the first quarter of 2020, we saw a large COVID-19 impact in the US and orders and revenue fell significantly. But a steady expansion of new customer base, flexible production system, and increase in the cost competitiveness of products, such measures were taken to improve the resilience structure. So in the fourth quarter of fiscal year 2020 was 118% year-on-year, and this recovery is still continuing. Both companies in the US that we acquired are implementing solid PMI and realizing growth and expansion despite the unprecedented difficult living and economic environment. Next is the expansion of total seamless solutions. Changes in the market conditions and aims of the industry sector. First, left side of the slide, changes in the market environment. This includes drastic changes due to COVID-19, increase in geopolitical risks, increasing environmental awareness, and shift to a recycling society. In response to that, on the center of the slide, the customers' management perspectives are changing as well. Environment, resilience, and security and safety. These three values are important. With the acceleration of DX, such as the reduction of required labor, automation, and contactless solutions that are becoming increasingly sophisticated in a new normal, the gaps between companies and organizations, the so-called boundaries that I mentioned in the last IR meeting, is becoming more evident. Solving this issue is becoming more important. Industry sector connects boundary through total seamless solution from workplace to management and solves issues to maximize customers' total profit and contribute to value creation. Next is the comparison to competitors. In this diagram, the vertical axis is the scope of the provision of solutions. From the bottom to the top, partial layer, adjacent layer, and full layers. Horizontal axis is the approach for resolution of customer issues. From left to right, package proposals, customer requirements, and collaborative creation with customers. And the size of the circle shows the ballpark revenue. With the changes in the market environment, boundary issue from market management to workplace and in supply chain is becoming evident. Therefore, it is more important to solve issues not only from individual optimization of partial layers, but also from overall optimization of the collaborative creation with customers and product, OT, and IT. So Hitachi will leverage and deepen total seamless solution based on domain SI knowledge to differentiate ourselves. Now, let me once again explain the total seamless solutions applied to boundary issues. The boundary issues exist in vertical, horizontal, and place. Starting with vertical, by connecting a boundary between management and workplace with digital, top management can understand workplace situation and make quicker decisions. Next, horizontal, by connecting boundaries such as manufacturing, supplier, distribution, and market with digital, we can enhance the efficiency through overall optimization. And lastly, place, a place where different industries connect with digital. When new places are born, people and information are connected and global market opportunities are created and new value creation opportunities are offered. So we will address these boundary issues with total seamless solutions. This shows the expansion of total seamless solutions utilizing Lumada. In co-creation with customers, the three mentioned at the bottom, the technologies are like AI and mathematical optimization technology, domain knowledge, and customer relations are the three strengths that support us. Today, let me talk about the ones in the yellow, the recent case examples. Starting from the next slide. So this will be a lot of information, but in order for you to understand the aim and the progress of the business in our sector, we will introduce the outline of six Lumada digital solution cases. First is connect supply chain globally. Right side, green box. We respond to the value chain that changes variedly and contribute to employees' work style reform through automation of planning of Daikin. For Daikin's chemical business, 5 manufacturing bases and 9 sales bases are connected globally to provide production and sales planning and execution support solutions that quickly respond to changes in demand. On the left side of the slide, SCM, by using SCM optimization simulation, we can present approximately 60 times more manufacturing and sales measure patterns than before in the short time. And the effects of introduction is shortening the time to determine by approximately 95%. With that, the bottlenecks through switching manufacturing can be eliminated and high profitable products by utilizing surplus capability can be increased. The supply chain aiming to maximize business KPI can be optimized. Second is the connect sales workplaces and markets. On the right side, green box again, please. Say you had cumbersome order placement operation. This was reduced drastically, which allows focusing on kitchen operations and customer services. In the future, they will aim to reduce stockouts and food loss. In workmen, we contributed to stockout control and inventory optimization of 100,000 items that have different sales turnover ratios. Now, the left side of the slide, please. These uses Hitachi's digital solution for retail AI demand forecasting based on automatic order placement service. And the effects of introduction for workmen is the shortening of order placement operation from approximately 30 minutes to 2 minutes. In both cases, these are the cases where Hitachi contribute to productivity improvement of sales workplace by automating order placement operation based on demand forecast by AI. And third is Monotaro case to connect workplace and management in logistics field. Green box on the right again, respond to labor shortage through automation using robotics and realize data originated and sophisticated operation of the distribution center. Now, bottom part in Monotaro's workplace, 300 compact and low floor automated guided robot Rakuro has been delivered with 400 more planned to be delivered. And Hitachi is managing all control systems and WCS. Now WMS, refreshment. A distribution center was sophisticated through WMS renewal and use of robotics. We aim to optimize. And fourth is connect workplace and management and logistics field, green box. Respond to decrease in number of truck drivers, accident preventive measures, and real-time operation management utilizing IoT technologies. This uses Hitachi Transport System's unique safe operation management solution using AI and Hitachi digital solution for logistics. On the bottom of the slide, you can see biological data of driver and the vehicle behavior and other driving operation information is accumulated on the cloud and managed and analyzed to realize both safety and efficiency improvement. Fifth case, provide a place for connecting different companies. Alfresa, through collaborative creation with pharmaceutical wholesaler Alfresa, we provide Japan's first platform for integrated management of cell and tracing information throughout the value chain for regenerative medicine products. To respond to strict quality control and traceability and analyze and simulate the supply chain. In regenerative medicine, it is crucial for multiple companies and organizations to share individual sample identification information to ensure product quality. So we offer common service infrastructure for all stakeholders involved in regenerative medicine products and connect boundaries existing between different companies and organizations. And sixth case is connect workplace management and supply chain in food field. So we contribute to the production system that quickly responds to change in demand and reducing environmental burden of Nichirei. Left side of the slide, by introducing Hitachi's proprietary system combining AI and mathematical optimization technology, time required to automatically produce optimal answer from among maximum 16 trillion production plan patterns per plant was shortened to 1/10. Now, shows the improvement of refrigeration equipment of Nichirei Logi Group in charge of logistics, product, OT, IT, Emilia-based cloud service infrastructure, integrated energy facility management service is offered. We also offer a solution to improve operation maintenance efficiency of refrigeration equipment. Next is the global growth development. This is the progress in North American market. In July 2017, we added Sol Air and strengthened the North American product business. And next we entered into robotics SI business. That is expected to show high growth, and KEC in April 19 and JR Automation in December and Kyoto Robotics in April 2021 to enhance and expand robotics SI business. We will collaborate with Global Logic going forward to reinforce the fusion of robotics SI and digital, and from fiscal year 2022, we will develop this into end-to-end digital solution connecting management and workplace. Now, we established Hitachi Industrial Holdings America to manage the North American business of industry sector strategy with Solair and JR Automation under the umbrella in April 2020. The ones in blue will be explained from the next slide onward. First is fusion of robotics SI and digital. JR Automation offers automation of large-scale robots processing equipment and conveyor collaboration between ERP and MES for the process of aircraft components of Rolls-Royce in North America and offering the optimization solutions. On the lower right, you can see the business formation. We have partnership with Siemens and ABB as well, and JR Automation is managing the entire project in a turnkey manner. Going forward, Hitachi and JR Automation synergy, including Global Logic, will accelerate the fusion of robotics SI and digital and expand the business. Next is the strengthening the functions of robotic SI acquisition of Kyoto Robotics. It has intelligent robotic system equipped with world-class 3D vision sensor. And we will leverage this to strengthen our robotics SI business.
99.99% 3D object recognition rate, masterless, and industry-leading depalletizing capability will become our strong weapon to strengthen our logistics and FA domain business. Now, this is the use case of intelligent robotic systems. This is a case of NTT Docomo's logistics operation reform and optimization. Upgrading of logistics center operation through OT and IT is promoted towards full automation through Kyoto Robotics intelligent robotic system. We started connecting the operation reform for logistics optimization. And from 2017, material handling, WCS, WMS, OT, and IT efficiency was realized. And from 2021, we've been utilizing 3D vision of Kyoto Robotics to automate the workplace through piece picking robot to aim for full automation of more sophisticated logistics center. Now, this is the strengthening of global development of robotics SI business. First, strengthened robotic SI feature digital fusion through the execution of cross-regional comprehensive activities. We use North American strategy of Hitachi Industrial Holdings America as a basis and strengthen integrated activity across borders using technology, know-how of JRA, KEC, Kyoto Robotics, and Hitachi. And use that as a basis to expand globally to Europe, ASEAN, and Japan. Now, conclusion. Initiatives for creating environmental value. We will create sustainable environmental value as well as economic value through collaborative creation with customers. In digital solutions business, we will reduce CO2 by optimizing production, supply chains, and distribution. And in utility solution business, we reduce CO2 by making advanced technology-driven improvements to the efficiency of water resources cycling systems. And in industrial products business, reduce CO2 by applying energy saving and or IoT schemes to products. In the industrial sector, we create sustainable environmental value by offering total seamless solutions. Now, this shows the intensive action for the growth of the industry sectors. There are three main intensive actions. From the left, facilitating the evolution of total seamless solutions, accelerating growth globally, and strengthening the management base. With this, we will aim for the business growth and business value enhancement in the industry sector. And lastly, conclusion. By implementing the business strategy and intensive actions for future growth, we forecast revenues of 880 billion yen, adjusted operating income ratio of 8.2%, overseas revenue ratio of 24%, and ROIC of 8.7% for fiscal year 2021. And beyond that, we will aim to achieve revenues upward of 1 trillion yen and adjusted operating income ratio exceeding 10% as the best solution partner for industrial customers. This concludes my explanation. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much, Aoki-san. We would now like to start the Q&A session. The question will be answered by Mr. Aoki, as well as Vice President and Executive Officer, CEO of Industry and Distribution Business Unit, Mr. Kazunobu Morita, and CFO of Industry Business Division, Mr. Kazuyuki Irie. If you have questions, please press the raise hand button on the Zoom screen. We will call your name, so please unmute yourself and mention your name and affiliation and ask your question. We will start from the Japanese channel. Media, institutional investors, analysts, anyone is okay. Any questions? Mr. Harada, please unmute yourself. Hello. Question. I have two questions. First, you raised many use cases. Co-creation with customer is increasing. This was very easy to understand and clear. I liked it. And with this, how much increase in revenue are you seeing, or the added value or profit? how much increase are you realizing? It's still difficult to image. So on page 17 and 18, for example, with these solutions, how much increase are you seeing? Could you quantify if you can? That's my first question. Second question is about the operating income ratio, profitability. In the industrial and machinery segment in general, when the logistics turns stronger, you can achieve double-digit profitability in many cases. Some of your products are at that level already, but overall, double-digit profitability is not achieved yet. In looking at your plan this fiscal year, it's 8%. So it is still falling short of the double digit. So when you target 10%, for example, what are you lacking? What is your shortcoming? What do you need? So you do collaborative creation, and the outcome of the co-creation will lead to higher profit and will bring you up to 10%. If you could give us an image, I would appreciate it. Answer. Thank you for the question. So the first question is the collaborative creation type solution. How much is the outcome reflected in numbers? It is difficult to answer, especially for fiscal year 2020. As the COVID impact, overall impact, the base dropped by 15%. So JR Automation was acquired, and so we have to make adjustments and corrections, but my image is from the 15% drop, we were able to come up by 10% through these solutions. So increase of 10%. So when we recover to fiscal year 19 level, last year, we wanted to aim for 900 billion or above in fiscal year 2021. So if we assume that this impact will disappear, then we think we can recover to that level. That's how much increase we're seeing in the solution sales. Now, how are we contributing to the profit? I think that was part of your question. There are still very challenging solutions. So I'm not saying the profitability is bad, but the value there. And I think this is related to your second question. We have products in our business too. So the cost is incurred. And the key is how much business we can increase where we can be paid for higher value, added value. So that will be the key. So there are more key cases. I just talked about some of them today and talked about boundaries. So offering the big breakthrough will become Hitachi's value and a value, big value for our customers, not just simple cost reduction, a bigger value than just simple cost reduction. So that is what we call by total seamless solution. So the product volume is necessary. We need that. In fiscal year 2021, this year, the base business is, we are a manufacturing company, so we are impacted by the market condition, good and bad market condition, and we cannot help it because we are a product manufacturer. But once we recover to the normal volume level, then we think we are strong enough to be able to see 10% in sight. I hope I answered your question.
Question. Thank you very much. Yes, you answered my question. Thank you.
続きまして。
Next is Mr. Ezawa. Please unmute yourself and pose your question in Japanese. Question. So I would like to know about the planning for the performance. This fiscal year's performance planning, the sales revenue will still be impacted by COVID-19, so it would not be growing so much. But in terms of the profitability, it will be going to 8.2%, is significantly higher. So at what stage are you in currently to get to this level of numbers? So could you talk from a qualitative perspective? You talked about solution business. That even though your business was impacted by COVID, solution was not impacted so much. So that's why the profitability is going up, even though the sales revenue is staying flat. So could you talk a little bit about that? And the second question is, if you look at your midterm plan, so there is an increase of 100 billion yen in revenue, and the margin will go up to around 10%. So if the revenue goes up, the marginal profit of the 10% can be achieved. So do you think that there would be a linear growth? Could you explain a little bit about your view on this? The business mix will be changing to total seamless solution. And I believe that in that case, there would be higher profitability. So I would like to know how you view this. Answer. Thank you for your question. The profitability for fiscal year 21. Improvement of the profitability and how we accumulate the sales revenue. I think that I should elaborate further on those points. For fiscal year 21 in sales revenue, compared to the increase in sales revenue, the profitability tends to go up higher. So this target, it's not something that's easy to achieve, but by having a recovery in the volume, the profitability will be going up, but that's about half the story. In terms of the contents, so the recovery of North America market, which was hit hard by COVID at first, and also Japan market and the global market. Under COVID environment, we now know the optimal fixed costs. And during fiscal year 20, we have conducted various initiatives, but for fiscal year 21, we clearly know what the costs incurred are. In fiscal year 20, we did see some losses, so we are able to see more clearly about what those losses are. And so with that in mind, we believe that we can achieve 8.2% in profit, which is 72 billion in value. And we believe that this number is achievable. Going further, so your question is that, is 10% sufficient for the 1 trillion yen that we are aiming at? In our business, we still have room for growth. 50% of the total is related to solution business. And now at hardware is less than half. So the marginal profit is not linearly going up just with the increase in the volume. We are focusing on SI. So if the utilization of the plant is 100%, the marginal profit will be going up, but our business is not like that anymore. In the midterm plan, we would like to, of course, aim higher. But we are not a simple hardware business anymore. So the style of generating profit will be different going forward. That's all for my answer. Thank you.
Next, we will take questions from the English channel. If you have any questions, please use the raise hand button. Any questions? We do not see any questions on the English channel, so we will shift back to the Japanese channel. Please raise your hand if you have questions. Mr. Yasui, please unmute yourself and ask your question. Question. I have three questions. First is the progress of digitalization due to COVID. This is a big theme. In the industrial sector, did this actually happen? You may say the change was not as big as we anticipated, or just an image, your take on how much digitalization progress you saw, or the changes in the business model, or paradigm shift. If you could talk about that, appreciate it. Second question, in the presentation material, page 12, JR Automation, sorry, page 11, JR Automation. Profit improvement, especially in medical, a big improvement. Revenue has doubled. And medical is growing. So maybe this is too big an improvement, a one-off improvement due to COVID. So will there be a reactionary fall? Is this sustainable? And third question, Aoki-san. When we acquired JR Automation, Solair and JR Automation combined, revenue was 130 billion yen. And there are many customers. So you said you want to aggressively expand the business. This time you acquired Global Logics too. So as mentioned by Tokunaga-san about the expansion plan of in North America, both quantitative or qualitatively, could you talk about the growth rate from the companies that we acquired? Thank you. Answer. So let me answer your third question first. I think it was the IR day in fiscal year 2019. We were said that those acquisition in North America were mid-size acquisitions. So that was total 130 billion yen. And we said we want to increase this to 200 billion yen. For fiscal year 20, it seems like we stepped back. But looking at the recovery from the second half, this target of 200 billion seems to be achievable or reasonable target for 2024 midterm management plan or fiscal year 25. In that time frame, we think we can achieve 200 billion. the automation in the US and capital expenditure trend are solid and steady. It's progressing steadily. And US-led digitalization and automation is now much stronger than what we thought and felt before the acquisition. And I talked about one digital case, and I cannot talk about many cases because we cannot talk about customers' names, but many SI operators and digital are integrated. The movement towards the smart factory is strongly advancing more than in Japan. And more complex digitalization was considered when we acquired JR Automation, but this time we also acquired GlobalLogic. So various delivery structure is now in place. So one missing piece was filled, was acquired, and this will be Hitachi's strong weapon going forward. So to repeat myself, the 200 billion yen target we think is achievable. And your second question was the question on the pie chart on page 11. Medical is growing significantly. It says revenue, but I think this is orders. No? I think this is order number. In terms of order, as you correctly mentioned, order nearly doubled year-on-year basis. And it does not show numbers here. So it's, I'm sorry, this is not clear cut, but automotive ratio declined, but this is not a drastic decline. It is not declining much. Automotive is not declining much. Medical care, and this includes general industries, grew significantly. And as you correctly mentioned, part of this is special demand. The COVID countermeasure, the warp speed strategy was implemented. Operation Warp Speed was implemented in the US. And JR Automation's strength is that we can respond in an agile fashion. And we recognized the strength once again. So I'm sorry, this was revenue. It's not orders, it's revenue. I'm sorry, I was wrong. So you said maybe we will see a decline in fiscal year 2021. This is partially incorporated into our budget. But looking at the order trend this year, the momentum has been maintained. The special one-off demand part will decline, but the automotive, thanks to the EV shift, backed by the environmental trend, including the emerging new players, we are seeing a big shift to EV. So the speed and the dynamism of the investment is seen. And when it comes to EV, the vehicle structure changes dramatically. The structure changes. And so the automation line to meet that is a must. For tier one manufacturers, it's indispensable. And so this trend will not stop. And as I mentioned in today's cases, adding digital to that will be our growth factor, our driver, and our differentiating factor. And your first question was about COVID-19, the paradigm shift of digitalization under COVID. Remote work and Daikin's example is about changing the product this way or changing the product from line A to line B. It's simple if it's just about one factory, but if it is a shift from a factory in France to factory in the US, it will be a big move. And it requires face-to-face discussion. But with this solution, we can have simulation in the headquarter and decide everything. So this will be one needs that can be met in the remote situation. Morita-san, anything to add? Thank you. I am Morita from the Industry and Distribution Business Unit. So regarding your first point, is there really a digitalization needs under COVID? As Aoki-san just mentioned, for example, in the case of Daikin, COVID and the geopolitical reasons, supply chain is changing now. So given these changes, where should products be made? How? The source of profit is now showing effect. And Monotaro and Hitachi Transport System, the co-creation example was shared. Even before COVID, people started coming less to the manufacturing sites. This had been a challenge. And with COVID, this challenge has become more evident and has been shifting at a greater speed. So we can solve these challenges through digital. So this digitalization needs is emerging and becoming more evident and accelerating under COVID. So it's surfacing and accelerating at the same time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's time for us to conclude this session.